Okay, hello again. This is HK21. This is my third custom pistol review that I've done on YouTube. Now then, this is a review of a pistol I did quite a while ago now. Actually, it was one of my first custom pistols that I ever built. I've also done another video which I put up ages ago, which is this particular gun firing at my local airsoft site. It's been a very, very good gun to use, and obviously by the paraphernalia that's in front of you here, you can guess what gun it is. It's the pistol that Keanu Reeves uses in the film StreetKings. It's his own home pistol. It's not the pistol that you see in the first gunfight at the very start of the film. That is a Smith & Wesson 4506, which, a shame, but there is no airsoft version of that pistol. As I'd like to have one, but there isn't one. No, this is the pistol he uses later on in the film to take out the two, bad guys, I suppose, who are undercover cops, the two black guys later on. It's based on a 1911. It's a 1911 A1. It's the Tokyo Marie pistol. It's been modified by having 9-ball slide stop, extended slide stop. It's got a standard TM 5.1 double thumb safety, ambi thumb safety. It's the silver version, because in the film his pistol for some reason has that. The actual slide itself is a standard 1911 slide. The only thing I've done to it is I've fitted my own foresight, which has been tapped and drilled into the front there. The original was cut off. It's had a Bomar sight fitted to the rear, which, to put it bluntly, was a pain in the arse to fit, but I managed to get it to work okay. The only other thing I've done is flared and lowered the ejection port, as per the real steel, or as per the one in the film. These are pictures, by the way, the real steel gun from the film. These are stills. As you can see, the slide stop is the same. Safety is pretty much the same, although I believe that safety is a Wilson combat safety, which you can't get for airsoft parts, at least not for Marui pistols anyway. I think you can get it for Western Arms, but you can't get it for Marui. So this one will have to do. It's as near as I can get it. As you can see, Bomar sight. It has a three-hole trigger, which this one is a Garda three-hole trigger. Again, Garda trigger. I swear by them. They're really, really good. The finish you get is exceptional. They all come with a over-travel adjustment, which gives it that bit of realism. The barrel is a standard 1911 barrel. As you can see, this one's getting worn now. It's where I've sprayed it, but the paint's wearing off. But I think that gives it that that sort of real steel look. So it's a standard 1911 barrel, standard barrel bushing, standard plug. Everything on this pistol, other than the few bits I've told you, is standard. The only things that, other than what I've told you, that aren't standard are the grips. These are actually from a WE CQB pistol, which I bought a number of years ago now when it first came out. And to be quite honest, wasn't very happy with the pistol, which I've since sold on. But the grips, for some reason, stayed with me, and I'm glad they did, because these match near enough identical to what's in the film. Only his ones in the film are magwell grips, i.e. they don't have this cutout at the bottom. They actually go all the way down to the bottom of the frame. And there's a magwell frame addition that's put on the bottom. There is a word for it, beveled magwell, that's right, which is actually joined to the mainspring housing, which I've as yet to buy, but I expect I will get one eventually, which is, as I say, joined to the mainspring housing. This is a Tanya Coba mainspring housing, as I've used on most of my pistols. It's from the Tanya Coba parts set, which you can get from War Games Club. Same as a hammer. Hammer is Tanya Coba. And that's pretty much it, really. The magazines, as per the ones in the film, are MEU magazines, but what I've done to them is I've just ground off this front edge to make them look more like I presume they are, I'm not sure, but I presume the real steel ones that are used in the film are Ed Brown, who has this distinctive angled edge front to the bumper on the bottom of them. So I've done the same to the MEU ones. They work pretty well. I don't get any leakage or anything. Funnily enough, these ones have had, actually I might as well show you that, these ones have had Garda rubbers put in them to give them a bit more gas flow. They seem to work pretty well. You do get quite a bit of gas ejection. It gives it more power during the summer, but during the winter you seem to lose more gas than actually gain any power, but there you go. Yeah, and that's pretty much it really. I've filled all of the original 1911A1 markings on the slide, because in the film, as you can see, it's all pretty much flush. I think the film one is just literally a custom made 1911, either that the character that Keanu Reeves plays with has played with it and done his own bits to it to make it his own sort of design. So that's why I think he's done away with all the logos and markings and everything else on it. But yeah, that's pretty much it. The only other thing I've done, obviously, is the grip safety, which I've had to grind the tangs down on the original 1911 frame to get it to fit. Again, Tanya Cobra, all part of the parts set. It's getting a bit worn now over the years, because I do use this pistol quite a bit. Yeah, other than that, it's a good pistol. Thoroughly enjoy using it. It's getting a bit worn now. The old slide's getting a bit rattly. As I say, it's a plastic slide, and there is quite a bit of movement there. I should imagine eventually I'll replace that slide with a new one and do all the custom bits to it again once this one wears out. The actual frame itself, being metal, is pretty good. It's it hasn't worn a lot at all really in down in there. It's pretty good, although I keep all my guns as clean as I can. That's the secret with airsoft pistols, is keep them well clean and lubricated as well. The amount of pistols I see come to me when I have to do repairs on them that are just purely not lubricated. They're not looked after, and it's a shame really, but there you go. But yeah, so that's it. It's a good pistol, good project. It was, as I say, one of the first ones I did, and I love her. I think she's great. But yeah, good film by the way. It is a good thriller. Keeps you guessing, I suppose, till the end. But yeah, good project. Thoroughly enjoyed it. Hope you enjoyed the review. Thanks very much. This is HK21, signing off.